Good morning, I'm Jeff Hard. We have breaking news at this hour here in the city of Greenville. A Greenville police spokesperson says that shots have been fired at officers near Malden Road and Wenwood Trail. Sean Mazzarello is on the ground near the scene. And Sean, what can you tell us from where you are this morning?
Jeff, I'm standing inside the perimeter, just inside the perimeter that authorities have set up here on Malden Road. It stretches from Cavalier all the way up to 85. I want you to look inside that, where those officers are standing. There are officers that have their guns drawn at this perimeter. Every stop point I've gone to, officers are out with their weapons. This is a very serious situation. I've seen dozens and dozens of law enforcement vehicles. Let's take a live look at Sky 4, further down from where I'm at, where this seems to be centering on Wenwood Road. That's where you mentioned Christ Church is. There's also the Berkeley Point Apartments. I saw a dozen or more law enforcement vehicles on that road alone.
The schools that are on lockdown at this time, Christ Church Episcopal School, also St. Joseph's Catholic Middle and High School, Sarah Collins Elementary, and Washington Center, also Greenville Tech, all on lockdown at this time. A very serious situation here near Malden Road and Wenwood Road after, according to Greenville Police, shots were fired at police officers earlier this morning. We first got word right around 10 o'clock. It is 11:06 right now. And of course, as you can see, a very serious situation. And we saw pictures there of the SWAT team near what it looked like an apartment building. Sean telling us there that Berkeley Point Apartments is in that area. But once again, we just don't know enough right now to know if that is where there is most concern at the Berkeley Point Apartments. So we don't want to speculate there, but that is right around the corner from there. And we understand that police are on their way over to where Sean is right now. So Sean, what's the latest here?
Jeff, I'm standing right now with Greenville Police Chief Terry Wilfong to brief us about what happened. Chief, what's going on?
I can basically just give you the prelim of what we have for now. So it's very rough information that I have to go on for now. Okay. One of our officers was checking an area and just running license tags, which is what they periodically do. A tag did not come back to a vehicle correctly. Checked into it, individual got into the vehicle. She then followed the vehicle up on 85 and tried to start a traffic stop. At that time, the individual started fleeing. She went down 85 as she could. He got off on the Maldi exit, and the vehicle continued to flee. At that time, she terminated the pursuit, which was within our policy because it was only going to be a traffic violation, nothing more. That pursuit was ended. At that time, two other officers came in the area, got a description of the vehicle. They went into an apartment complex. They actually located the vehicle, checked the vehicle, called the other officer. Yes, this is the vehicle. Ran the license plate. It came back to a different car, not a Yukon, which is what the vehicle she checked. At that time, she goes into the breezeway of the apartment to start checking. An individual popped up and started shooting at our officer. At that time, our officer sought cover, returned fire periodically. She sought cover again, and the individual fled. At this time, we do not know where the subject is. We got the information out. We did a reverse 911. Schools in the area chose to go on lockdown, and that's basically all I have for now.
It very much is a tense situation, Jeff, and I want to show you just how tense it is. Look at the roof of St. Joseph's Catholic High School. There are people actually on the roof looking out at the campus grounds, making sure that this suspect does not show up on school property. This school is in lockdown, along with a long list of other schools like Christ Church Episcopal, Sarah Collins, Washington Center, Greenville Tech, who you said canceled night classes tonight. The list goes on and on.
And we begin with News 4's John Eby just outside the search area. John, what's the latest from there?
Well, police have been scouring the wooded area behind me just off Malden Road all day. For hours, they've been looking in here for the man, but they say that he managed to catch a ride and drove away, and now he could be almost anywhere. The man they say they're looking for is 25-year-old Patrick Dean Lawrence. He's from Duncan. That mugshot you're going to see there is a little old now. They say his hair is long enough now to be in a ponytail. Police say he's wanted on several charges in Greenville County, including kidnapping and attempted murder. Now, police say an officer first tried to pull Lawrence over when the tags on the silver GMC Yukon he was driving came back as being from a stolen vehicle. He got away, but they found that SUV again at the Berkeley Point Apartments. One of the officers got out to investigate, and they say Lawrence ambushed her and started shooting. The officer wasn't hit, but she returned fire. Police say Lawrence may have been shot, and he ran off into these woods. That set off a search that closed down about a 3-mile area around the apartments for several hours. But again, he got away.
We believe that he was able to contact an individual, and they picked him up in a vehicle and got him out of the area because the dogs followed the track to the very end, which butted up to 291. So it appears that he got in a vehicle. He's no longer in our area.
Now, the sheriff's office has released some more information about the previous charges that Lawrence was facing. They said those stem from an attempted armed robbery at a Wendy's on Henry Dale Avenue on Sunday. They say he forced several employees out of the restaurant and fired shots at them before running away. They say somebody may be helping him avoid capture. They say if you know where he is or know who is helping him escape, please call 911 immediately.
At one point, 10 schools in Greenville were on lockdown. It first started with one school, Sarah Collins Elementary. Then in no time, St. Joseph's Catholic High School, J.L. Mann, even Virginia College were added to the list.
I know there was a shooter going on. I was at Greenville Tech this morning when it happened, and Greenville Tech went on lockdown.
By early afternoon, schools had to start figuring out what they were going to do about dismissal. First, Virginia College started sending students home, then St. Joseph's. Only after getting the okay from police did Greenville County announce it will allow its schools to have normal dismissal. Anxious parents just happy to have their kids back within arm's reach. Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
And tonight, all evening classes and events at Greenville Tech have been canceled.
We have breaking news.
And good evening, everyone. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. We begin with breaking news tonight on a story News 4 has covered all day.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local at the Greenville Memorial Hospital, where a man has been taken tonight. Mandy, what's the latest?
Well, Michael, investigators say Lawrence was hit in the shoulder during a shootout earlier with that officer. We're told that he was alert and conscious when he was brought here to Greenville Memorial. Well, about 2 hours ago, EMTs worked on Lawrence in an ambulance on Mormont Avenue, where he was found after a wild night for law enforcement. Officers say Lawrence was simply sitting in his wife's apartment when investigators knocked on the door, and they say he gave them no problems during the arrest. Now, this all comes after Lawrence's family put out a plea for him to turn himself in. Hours after police named Patrick Dean Lawrence as the focus of their manhunt, his mother put out a statement with tears in her eyes.
Patrick, wherever you are, please turn yourself in. If you are hurt, you need medical attention. Do know your family loves you and want you to do the right thing.
Verbena Kramer says she hasn't seen her son since Tuesday morning. The last time she'd heard from the 25-year-old was Wednesday via text. The family says they are cooperating with investigators to every extent possible.
He's not a violent person that I know of. I don't see or know of anything that would turn him to do something like this. I love Patrick, and I'm ready to help him any way I can within the law. I will not go outside of the law for him or anyone else.
It all started at this Comfort Inn on Lawrence Road, where an officer spotted an SUV with a license plate that didn't match. The officer says she tried to pull Lawrence over, but he took off. We're told another officer spotted the SUV outside this building at Berkeley Point Apartment Complex. Bullet grazes and holes can now be seen in the breezeway, where investigators say Lawrence opened fire on the officer. That officer then returned fire, and the police chief says, quote, a gun battle ensued. The officer wasn't hurt, but investigators say Lawrence was able to get away. After an exhaustive search with multiple law enforcement agencies, officers came up empty-handed. Lawrence's uncle put out a plea to his nephew.
Don't fight the police. It's a no-win. If you run across someone that's gun happy or may not have a chance to think, you may lose your life. Don't do it, son. It's not worth it.
Now, before all of this happened, Lawrence was wanted out of Greenville County for charges such as attempted murder, kidnapping, and robbery. Again, he was alert and conscious when he was brought here tonight to the hospital. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in Greenville.